This tutorial shows how to create a citation with multiple sources in Microsoft Word. Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a technical writer and editor who shares step-by-step software tutorials and writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my website at erinwrightwriting.com. There are several third-party plugins that can help you create citations with multiple sources in Microsoft Word. But today we're going to look at how to create multi-source citations in Word without using a plugin. We'll also look at how to remove or edit individual sources within a multi-source citation. These steps are based on the assumption that you've already entered your source information and created your single-source citations. We will very quickly walk through the steps to create a new source during the tutorial. But for complete instructions, please see my other tutorial titled How to Insert Citations in Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps will also work in Word 2019 and Word 2016. To create a citation with multiple sources, begin by placing your cursor where you want to insert the citation. Then select the References tab in the ribbon, followed by the Insert Citation button in the Citations and Bibliography group. Now select the first source you want to cite from the Insert Citation menu. Alternately, you can select Add New Source to create a new source. If that's your choice, add the source information in the Create Source dialog box, and then select the OK button. The single source citation should appear in your document. Now, place your cursor to the left of the closing parenthesis, and then reselect the Insert Citation button and select the second source you want to cite from the Insert Citation menu. The second source should be inserted within the existing parentheses. Continue to repeat these steps until you've added all the sources needed in the citation. Before we move on, please note that the punctuation inserted between the sources will depend on the style guide chosen for your citations in the Style menu in the References tab. For example, the Chicago and Turabian styles use commas between sources, and the APA and MLA styles use semicolons between sources. Now we're going to look at how to edit individual sources in a citation, including adding page numbers and removing information through suppression. To begin, select the citation and then select the Citation Options menu arrow. Next, select Remove Citation, Edit Citation, or Edit Source from the menu. The Remove Citation option lets you remove individual sources. Edit Citation lets you add page numbers or remove the author's name, year, or title through suppression. Edit Source lets you edit the source information. Now select the source you want to remove or edit from the menu. If you chose Edit Citation, enter the page number or numbers you want to insert, or choose to suppress, which is to remove, the author, year, or title. This choice won't affect other citations referencing this source. Select the OK button after you've made your choices. If you chose Edit Source, update the source information in the Edit Source dialog box, and then select the OK button when you're finished. It's important to note that Word will automatically update all other citations in your current document that reference the source you just edited. An alert box will appear asking how you want to save your source edits. Select the Yes button if you want to update the source in your master source list and your current source list. Select the No button if you only want to update your current source list. The individual source in your citation should now be updated. As always, save your file to save your changes. I have created many other videos about Microsoft Word, including how to create charts in Microsoft Word and how to create custom bullets in Microsoft Word. Please see the playlist titled How to Use Microsoft Word, which is linked below, for the complete list. The companion webpage for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on AaronWrightWriting.com, which is also linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Microsoft Word, Adobe Acrobat, or Google Docs that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials, and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.